Fishing is quite an entertaining and interesting sport. There are various types of rods or poles, as they are also called, which are available for fishing different species. However, to enjoy this sport, you have to know about its setup. Scroll down to know about it. On a bright sunny day, when the rain gods are resting, all you need is a fishing pole and off you go fishing. A tour with your family can be a great time to unwind and have unadulterated fun. But all your rosy plans for a nice time out can go for a toss if you do not know how to set the pole. How to set up a fishing pole? What fishing gear you need for the setup? Of course, apart from the rod, are reel, test line, small bead, hook, sinkers and bobber stop. Start by attaching the chosen fishing reel to your rod. Then making use of the reel seat, place the reel in it and tighten it. But ensure that you do not tighten it too much. Then let the reel be spooled to your test line. In fact, you can even buy a reel, which has been already spooled with a test line. Next, thread the test line up in your fishing rods, through the holes in the rod. To ensure that you can attach rest of the equipment, keeping a lot of slack in your line once you thread it. Follow it up by slipping your bobber stop onto the test line. The most easily available and popular is the rubber stop. That looks like a grain of rice with a hole at each end, which the test line is threaded through. This bobber stop is essential for keeping the bobber from sliding past the depth that you choose. Now, directly under the bobber stop, thread the small bead. This bead is crucial, that helps to keep the bobber stop from slipping down, in the situation of a fish being hooked and it pulls on the test line. Then slide your slip bobber up the test line. Next, through the eye of the hook thread the test line and then attach it to your test line. Follow it up by clipping two small split shot sinkers to the test line by using a pair of pliers. Then clip them around 10 inches above the hook and an inch or two apart from the two split shot sinkers. And last but not the least, put the bait of your preference on the hook and there you are, all set for freshwater fishing. You can use a bee moth, cricket, earthworm or minnow. But hey, you can go for other baits as well, you need not use just these. Then, if you want to go for trout fishing, you would need a spin cast pole. So here is how to do that. Setting up a fishing pole for trout. For setting a spin cast pole you need spin casting rod and reel with line, number 4 bait holder hooks, split shot sinker assortment, egg sinkers, 1/8 to half ounce, snap swivels, 6 pounds to 12 pounds test, live worms or minnows and lures, spinners, spoons or minnow lures. First thing you do is choose an ultra-light spin casting ensemble with a rod length of 4.5 feet for action on light line, 2 to 6 pounds test. Now ultralights cast lures or baits in the scale of 1/32 to 1/8 ounce. Purchase a light to medium weighing spin casting setup with a rod length of 5.5 to 6 feet for trout fishing in large to medium streams with lines weighing between 6 to 12 pound test. For durability, look for an ensemble with a reel that has minimum 2 ball bearings. Have a nightcrawler rig for fishing a live worm. This results in good trout catches, under almost any condition. Push a worm onto the hook. Start at the collar of the worm and slide it up above the bait holder barbs. Let the bait settle at the bottom after you cast the bait upstream. Until you feel the trout nibbling or hitting the line, keep on twitching the bait for letting it drift downstream with the current. In slack water or pools, fish in a live worm or a minnow with a bobber rig. Then attach the number 4 hook and clip a bobber about 3 to 4 feet above it. For the bait, use a minnow or a worm hook through its back. Cast to the various parts of the pool for attracting the trout to attack your bait. Thread a small egg sinker to your line. Follow it by pinching on a small split shot beneath the egg sinker, around 2 feet from the end of the line. Now tie on a number 4 bait holder hook and put on a wormtail hooked minnow or a worm. Finally, for fishing lures with a spin cast outfit, attach a snap swivel to the end of the line. With a uni knot, tie a 6 to 12 pounds test snap swivel on your line. You can snap on a spoon, spinner or a minnow lure for the purpose of cast and retrieve fishing. The snap swivel prevents the line from twisting and permits you to change lures quickly. Here was a brief description of how to go about setting a fishing pole. I hope I didn't confuse you and this was useful for enthusiasts. I sign off here.